Hello guys and welcome to Being Foodie, and today we are making one of the delicious recipe of all times, the chicken egg biryani, but this time in a rice cooker. So let's quickly get started. First of all, in a pan take biryani whole spices, roast them a little bit and grind them coarsely to make 2 tablespoons of biryani seasoning mix. Next, marinate the chicken. For that take 300 grams of chicken. Add 1/2 cup of hung curd or Greek yogurt, 2 tablespoons of ginger, garlic and onion paste. Then the dry spices including turmeric, chili, cumin powder and salt to taste. Squeeze 1/2 lemon and sprinkle the biryani seasoning mix you made earlier. And about 1 tablespoon of vegetable oil. And now it's time to make your hands dirty. Mix all the ingredients nicely. Cover and refrigerate for 1 to 2 hours. Now in a rice cooker, take water double the amount of the rice. I have taken 3 cups of water for 1.5 cup of rice. Add salt to taste, about 1 tablespoon of whole spices and about 1 tablespoon of vegetable oil. Now close the lid and switch on the cooker on rice cooking mode for 15 minutes. After 2 to 3 minutes, when the water is hot enough, add 1.5 cup of biryani rice, close the lid and let it cook for the rest of the time. After 15 minutes, check the rice and if any water is left over. Make sure the rice is 75% cooked. Take it out and keep it aside. Now in the same rice cooker, take the marinated chicken. No need to add oil as we have already added oil while marinating. Stir it a little bit. Now switch on the cooker on rice cooking mode for 20 minutes. It's been 20 minutes. Let's check it. The chicken are almost cooked. Don't worry about the gravy as this is due to the curd, onion and some water from the chicken. Because while cooking in a rice cooker, the water doesn't rise up completely and this is also going to help the biryani to cook perfectly. Now layer the rice on the top of the chicken. Place boiled eggs cut into halves. Now add fried onions. Then one more layer of rice and fried onions. Now sprinkle a handful of finely chopped coriander leaves. And 1/2 cup of saffron soaked warm milk. Close the lid and switch on the cooker in steam mode for 20 minutes. After 20 minutes, let it stand for 20 more minutes. While the biryani is cooking, let's make a simple onion raita to complement the biryani. For that, in a bowl, take 1 cup of curd, add chopped onions, finely chopped coriander leaves and finely chopped green chilies. Add salt to taste. Now sprinkle 2 to 3 teaspoons of black pepper powder. Pour water and mix it gently. Now put it in the fridge for 15 to 20 minutes. It's been 40 minutes. Now let's check and serve the biryani. The biryani is perfectly cooked. Now serve it on a plate. Serve the onion raita with it. And finally, it's time to taste. But not with a spoon, because biryani tastes best while eating with your hands. So thank you guys for watching Being Foodie, and if you like the video, then do subscribe, comment and share.